Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. This is the Jerusalem Temple Church of God in Christ. And on behalf of our pastor, Superintendent Ward L. Riley Sr., his wife, Missionary Mazel Riley, and the Jerusalem Temple Church family, we welcome and thank you for joining us in this video broadcast. If you want to contact us, feel free to call us at 662-686-7805 during our regular church hours, or at 662-771-1765 outside of our normal church hours. You can also email us at jtkojic@gmail.com. That's jtkojic@gmail.com, or through regular mail at P.O. Box 329, Leland, Mississippi 38756, or you can see us on Facebook. We encourage you to also give to the work of the ministry. Our financial giving information will be provided to you at the end of this video. After prayer, we'll be blessed by a song by Sister Freddie Grayson, followed by the Word of God by Elder L.C. Holmes. Please join us in prayer at this time. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy, O God. We thank you for your favor towards us, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, God, we bless your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, you are good and your mercy endures forever. Hallelujah. Oh God, we bless and magnify your name. We exalt you above all names, oh God. And Lord, we come before you right now. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we need you to move on our behalf. Hallelujah, God, we need you to touch that brother that's in a wheelchair, oh God. Touch his body. Raise him up in the name of Jesus. Touch our sister that's bedridden, oh God, that can't rise, oh God. We pray that you raise her up in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh God, we pray that you will speak healing into the troubled mind in the name of Jesus. All of those under the sound of my voice, oh God, whatever they need, God, we pray that you meet that need in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh God, you said in your word, I am the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? Hallelujah. And oh God, we come before you now, God. We need healing, Lord. We need your healing, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, reach out and touch. Reach out and touch, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, lay your hand on our brother. Lay your hand on our sister, Lord. Lay your hand on them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Let them know that you are the God that healeth thee. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And oh God, we pray that you will move through this video broadcast. In the name of Jesus, let your anointing flow, oh God. Hallelujah. Bless the songs of joy in the name of Jesus. Bless the word of God, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we will forever give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Look where he brought me from.
this. Can you just tell the Lord thank you?
Thank you.
Come on, tell him out of your heart, thank you. Tell him thank you. The song said, power of the Lord. And that's what we need in these times, in this hour, in this day. We need more power. And that's what we want to do. We want to look to the Lord. Amen for all things. We thank him for all his wonderful blessings. We thank him for all that he's done and that he's going to do. Amen. We thank him for what he's doing right now. Amen. In spite of what we are going through, we thank God. Amen. Though we'll be in this pandemic that we're going through. Amen. All of us are going through. Look like the whole globe is going through. Something that we've never gone through before. Amen. We've heard about it, but it hadn't hit home yet. But since it's hit home now, we know what it's like. Amen. Many are going there, having to go with the death of a loss of a loved one. And there are those that are going through the loss of job. Amen. And the loss of food. Amen. That just goes into the house and putting their refrigerators on the shelf. Amen. We're all suffering this pandemic. This is a global thing here. And certainly we thank God for being who he is. Amen. And we see that many of those that are leaving here by the way of death. Amen. Amen. They are good. Amen. And sometimes good suffer bad things. Amen. But the bad suffer good things as well. So we see what kind of God that we serve. He reigns on the just as well as the unjust. Amen. And we're just going to have to begin to see things like God sees. Amen. So we thank him for just being God. We thank him for who he is. Amen. He's all that we need, and all that we need is in him. Certainly we thank God for all his wonderful blessings. We thank God for the pastor, amen, who's not here, and First Lady Raleigh and family also. We thank God for Elder, amen, Dixon and family. Sister, amen, Dixon. Sister, amen, amen, Grayson as well, and all who's, amen, who will be listening in on this recording. Amen. We want you to know that we're praying for you. We want you to know that we're with you. We've got your back. And we realize and know that God has got our back. Amen. And we're praying and we're interceding for those that are sick, those that are bound, those that are going through and seem like don't know what to do. I want you to know that help is on the way. Amen. Amen. Those of you that have the Bibles, amen, if you will, First Kings, the 17th chapter, amen, we want to begin reading, amen, at verse 20, and it reads as follows. And he cried unto the Lord and said, O Lord my God, hast thou also brought evil upon this woman with whom I sojourn by slaying her son? And he stretched himself up upon the child three times and cried unto the Lord and said, O Lord, my God, I pray thee, let this child's soul come back into him again. And the Lord heard the voice of Elijah, and they were saying the soul of the child came into him again, and he revived him. And Elijah took the child and brought him down out of the chamber into the house and delivered him unto his mother. And Elijah said, See, thou son liveth. And then woman said unto Elijah, Now by this time I know that thou art a man of God, and that the word of the Lord is in thy mouth. In thy mouth is truth. Amen. Certainly, I would just like to just use briefly for a subject on today. Amen. Good news for bad times. Amen. Good news for bad times. Amen. And it's certainly we are living in bad times. We're living in hard, difficult, dangerous times. Amen. The devil is on the rampage. He's out to kill, and he's doing just that. And I'd just like to just read a little clip in here. Amen. That was wrote in reference to our 44th president. Barack Obama, just a few verses of it here. And this clip, and it said, before he became president of the United States, then Senator Barack Obama gave a policy address into which he stated, whatever we once were, we are no longer a Christian nation. At least not just. We're no longer a Jewish nation, a Muslim nation, or rather we are also a Jewish nation, a Muslim nation, a Buddhist nation, a Hindu nation, and a nation of non-believers, and that's the truth. It said many America no longer turn to the God of the Bible in times of crisis and in times of tragedy. We look all around us, amen. We see people are dying every day. People are going through it. Many just call it a hoax and they just brush it off the shoulder as though nothing has happened. Many are just turning to each other, turning to a sister or brother, turning to some kind of news media or outlet. But very few seem to be turning to God. And as we look slowly, they're beginning to turn to God and begin to cry out to the Lord, because they see now that this pandemic is no joke. Amen. This is the wake up the enemy. Amen. This is an email, a special delivery from the enemy. But this is really God's mail. We just have to just give it to the Lord. This is your mail. We can't handle this. This is too big for us to handle. You said, Lord, that the battle is not ours, but it's yours. So we're looking to you, Lord. We're going to stand still and see you move. We're going to see the salvation of the Lord, amen, in your movement. Amen. This is your mail, Lord. Can you just tell the Lord, thank you.
Thank you.
Amen. Can you just tell him thank you again?
Thank you.
So instead of turning to God in times of crisis, amen. Instead, they said, they wonder, well, what happened to God when 20 children, amen, died in the Newtown Massacre? Where was God during the Columbine school shooting when more than a decade ago? Where is God when one mass murder after another takes place? America is no longer a different nation now. They are no longer the same. But they are a different nation now, amen, than they once were. Amen. Once they were the arsenal of democracy. Amen. The world's biggest creditor nation. And now they are the debtor nation, questioning the long-held value, amen, that formed the entire American way of life. Yes, does God have anything to do with the plunge of America's international power and prestige? What about the remarkable change in weather patterns? Including the increasing seriousness of crop losses?
Yeah.
Amen. In the specter of food rationing, what about the growing drought in America? Midwest and Southwest that has become so severe that the government is beginning to being forced to dynamite, amen, portion of the Mississippi River because of the waterways or the water levels too low, amen, for massive barges containing millions of tons of grain and other food and stuff, amen, are often unable to navigate their way through the vital waterways. Well, what about the increasing strain in our medical facilities, especially the threat of prophesied epidemics, amen, on the horizon? What about the record number of massive earthquakes coming closer and closer to America's shore? What about it? It's time for us to cry out to God. It's time for us to look to God and cry out to them, let him know, Lord, we are in trouble and we need you. We look there, people are worried about, because of the thought of a recession. Amen. They are in a state of withdrawal, of fear, or a state of retreat. Yes, they are socially and emotionally detached. Most of them have become unhappy, amen, angry, and bitter, amen, another state of rage, of rejection, and rebellion. Yes, people are hurting because of financial setbacks. Marital problems, they are stressed over lack, job layoff, pink slips, companies closing down, amen, fire, amen, for wrong reasons, abuse from bosses and sexual harassment. Yes, amen, these are the times that we live in. These are the end times. These are crucial times, hard, difficult times. And followed by sadness, sorrow, depression, despair, despondency, anger, and bitterness. foreclosure, amen, cruel and unfair landlord continues to evict men. Lights off, gas off, water off, telephone is shut off. Problem after problem. Yes, my friend, these are the end times. These are the times, amen, that the Bible talks about in Matthew 24. Yes, these are hard, difficult, dangerous times. We see here in our text, I want to go back to verse 1 here in the same text, 1 Kings 17. And it says, and Elijah the Tishbite was also, who was an inhabitant of Gilead, said unto Ahab, as the Lord God of Israel liveth, before whom I stand, there shall be no dew nor rain these years, but according to my word. Amen. But according to my word. And then it said that the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Get thee hence, turn thee eastward, and hide thyself in the brook Cherith. Amen. And that is before Jordan. And you will find there, and it will be that ye shall find drink there in the brook. And I have commanded the raven to feed thee. And this is what the prophet did. He did specific instructions that at the brook Cherith, amen, that is before Jordan. And the Bible said that and the raven brought him bread and flesh in the morning and bread and flesh in the evening, and he drank water. And he did as the Lord has told him. Yes, he followed instructions of the Lord. Amen. He stayed there until the brook dried up. Amen. Can we say amen? I say he stayed there until the brook dried up. But while he was there, the Bible lets us know that his dependence was on God. Amen. And this is what we're going to do. We're going to have to depend on God in times like these. Amen. In times of pandemic, we're going to have to depend on God. Amen. Can we say amen? The Bible says in St. John 15:5, I am the vine and ye are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. And we can't do nothing with God. All we need is in Jesus. Amen. Can we say amen? Amen. The Bible also says that God was Elijah's divine supplier. And he took divine care of him, amen, as well. Yes, God is also your divine supplier. For all we need is in him. Amen. What is it that you need? Amen. Amen. We can get it from God. I know when we talk, when we pray, we talk to God and we look and we see things the way they are, that they are. Amen. And we wonder, amen, we wonder sometimes how is this going to be? But God moved in mysterious ways. God touched the heart of people and they moved. And seemingly they hear and understand what God is saying. Amen. Sooner or later, perhaps a check comes through the mail. Amen. With your name on it, and you know that you, amen, these people don't know you. And you're looking there, and that check says to such and such a name with X number of dollars. Amen. God, and the Bible never said how God is going to move, but we know that he's going to move. Amen. Give us amen. Amen. They used to sing a song and years ago, you got to move, you got to move. When God gets ready, you got to move. Amen. So it's time to move and go back to the basics. It's time to go back to prayer. Amen. Give us amen. Amen. Yes, the Bible also says in Psalm 115 and verse 12 that the Lord has been mindful of us. Amen. He will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel, and he will bless the house of Aaron. God has, he keeps you in mind. Amen, amen. He keeps you in mind. Amen. It's just like a tattoo. His name is written, a tattoo in the palms of his hand. Amen. And when at the remembrance of you, he looked in the palms of his hand, he sees you there. Or you can write. Perhaps you've been in school and you want to write a message in your hand that you might remember because it has reference to your subject. And every time you open your hand, you realize and remember why that message is in your hand. Well, this is the way it is. He said, our names are written in the palms of his hand. Amen. Give us amen. Amen. Shall we say amen again? Amen. Yes, the Bible also says in Matthew 6, amen, in verse 6 and verse 32. Amen. Matthew 6 and verse, amen, 32. And I want to get it again here, verse 30. It said, wherefore if God, amen, so clothed the grass of the field, amen, which the day is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith. Verse 31 said, therefore take no thought, saying, what shall we eat? Or what shall we drink? Or whether shall we be clothed? Verse 30 and 32 is that for all of these things do the Gentiles seek after. And for your heavenly Father knoweth that you have need of all these things. God knows what you need. Yeah. Amen. Nobody have to tell him what you need. God knows everything. Yeah. The Bible said that God, amen, that God has all, he's all power. He's all knowing. Yeah. Amen. He's everywhere present at the same time. You don't have to go nowhere because he's already there. Right. Amen. All he had to do, just speak a word and conditions in your mind, soul, and body will change. Yeah. All he has to do, just send his word to heal you, deliver and set you free and change conditions. Yes, God is all that we need. Amen. We don't have to go nowhere. We could just get up early in the morning and begin to pray, begin to call out upon the name of Jesus. Amen. Just begin to call his name. Amen. I mean from the heart, not merely just say Jesus, but begin to call upon the name of the Lord from down on the inside. Amen. And I tell you, God can't resist faith because he sees it. I believe when he hears his name, he hears faith. Amen. He knows the heart of the individual. He knows our heart, our mind, our thoughts. Amen. Can we say amen? Shall we say amen again? Amen. Amen. God is a good God. Amen. Shall we say amen again? Yes, he's a good God. And then the Bible says here, amen, also in St. Luke 12 and 7, it says, but even the very hairs on our head are all numbered. So fear not, therefore, ye are more valuable than many sparrows. Don't you know that God knows, he said he knows your head, the hairs on your head are numbered. Well, I know that I've lost some and I'm a few sharper than I was last year, but God knows every number. And not only does he know the number of the hairs on your head, he knows the one of the wig that you got on your head. God knows the number. Amen. Can we say amen? Shall we say amen again? Yes, the Bible also says in 1 Peter 5 and 7, casting all your cares, but not some of them, but casting all your cares upon you, for he cares for you. Amen. God cares for you. He cares about your life. He cares about your feelings. He cares about your aches and your pain. He cares about whether you're going through, and he sympathizes with our suffering. He's all that we need in times like these. As we go through this pandemic, amen, all we need is Jesus. Amen. Shall we say amen? Yes, we must pray. We must seek him. Amen. We must seek him one for another, or one toward another. He's my everything, somebody say it. Shall we say amen again? He's my everything. Yes, and the Bible says here in Elijah, in 1 Kings 17, and it says, and the word of the Lord came unto me again, the prophet said, arise and get thee to Zarephath, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. And behold, I have commanded the widow to sustain thee there. Now you see, there was a drought. Amen. There was a drought here, and then there was a famine. Amen. Here in this particular passage here, it began in the third miracle. There's a drought here. There's a famine here. And these are bad times. These are difficult times. Amen. In droughts and amen. In famines, amen. Amen. Even in the continent of Africa, just about the whole continent of Africa is a drought. Amen. There's no rain. Amen. There's no greenery. You can't plant no garden because there won't nothing grow. Amen. Can we say amen? Yes, so amen. So the Lord says here, I have commanded, amen, a widow there to sustain thee. Amen. Don't you know that people need to be sustained in these times? People are worried about where their next meal is coming from. Go to the store, there's nothing on the shelves. Amen. There's nothing on the shelf. I mean, necessities that we're used to having, they're no longer there. Amen. Many of us just take things for granted that we go there, that it'll all be there. But people are getting up early in the morning, going to the stores to look for these items. And they're no longer there. Amen. Don't you know that God is the same way? Amen. They go there because they want the best spoil. Amen. And this is the way God is toward us. He wants the best store, best oil. Have you ever went to the store early in the morning and you go to the produce area? Amen. And when you go there, you be the first to get there to get your produce. And then as people go in, sooner or later, that pile is going to go down. Amen. And when the pile goes down and gets down to the bottom, and look like from the weight of what was on the bottom, the weight on top, amen, had beat it all up, beat it all down, tell it just don't look right. And it stayed there until they changed and put fresh produce in there because they wanted the best oil. And that's the way God has taught us. He wants the best oil. This is why he takes some. I allow others to leave here. Amen. During pandemics and other, it's not because they've done nothing bad. Amen. But it's just the idea that bad things happen to good people and good things happen to bad people. Amen. Keep us amen. Yes, but God wants the best oil, just like everybody else do. Amen. Keep us amen. Keep us amen again. If he just said, well, I'm just going to let good things happen to the good people and bad things happen to the bad people, then the church would never grow. Amen. The sinner never would receive salvation. Amen. She would say amen again. He would never receive salvation. The goodness of the Lord, the goodness of thee, the Bible say, wake, amen, wake of repentance. Amen. And when a sinner repent, amen, and turn to God, amen, then he's no longer a sinner. Amen. He's saved. He's delivered. He's been set free. Amen. And he then now, amen, can be a vessel unto the Lord. And amen. A vessel unto the Lord. Amen. Amen. And prepared and one that will be able to receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Yes, so the Bible say that he arose. Amen. Elijah arose and went to Zarephath. And when he came to the gate of the city, the Bible said that the widow woman was there gathering sticks. And he called unto her and said unto her, fetch, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel that I may drink. And again, he said, as she was going to fetch it, he called her and said, bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in thine hands. Amen. And she said, As the Lord thy God liveth, I have not a cake. But a handful of meal in a barrel, amen, and a little oil in a cruse. And behold, I gather two sticks, amen, that I may go and dress it for me and my son, that we may eat and die. Amen, amen. But you know, there was something about the lady, the type of lady that she was, amen, and the type of lifestyle that she lived. She heard and followed the instruction of the prophet. Amen. She did as he said. Amen. So the Bible said that Elijah said unto her, fear not, and go and do as thou hast said. Make me therefore a little cake first, and then bring it unto me, and then afterward make one for thee and thy son. Amen. And that's strange. Amen. A lot of people would think it's strange. Amen. And they would say, well, this guy, he's trying to get away or something, you know, and about what the prophet had said unto her. Amen. And she went and did as the prophet had said. Amen. Give us amen. Amen. And the Bible says in verse 14, it says, but thus saith the Lord God of Israel, the barrel of meal shall not waste, neither shall the cruse of oil fail until the day that the Lord sent it rain upon the earth. Amen. That was a long time back this time. Three years and six months. Amen. Just think every time. Can you just imagine having meal in your barrel? And every time you take a cup of meal out your barrel or pour a cup of oil out of your cruse, amen, the measure is still the same. Yeah. Amen. The measure is still the same. Yeah. Nothing goes out, but only the miracle is still taking place. And the Bible said, until God sent rain upon the face of the earth. Amen. Can we say amen? That's the kind of God we serve. Amen. He's the God. He's good news in bad times. All you need to do is to pick your word and begin to read about him. Read about the miracles that he wrought. Read about how he touched people, how he raised the dead. Amen. How he gave sight to the blind, opened up deaf ears. Amen. And how he opened the hearts that were stubborn. Amen. Just read about the things that he did. And you can see that he's doing the same thing. You may not see as much of it because we live in a generation of the millennium now, and something is wrong with them. Something wrong with them. Amen. Can we say amen? But we are still serving the same God. He's still the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He's still the same today, yesterday, and forever. And he changed not. Amen. Can we say amen? Shall we say amen again? Shall we say amen again? And then the Bible says, and the bell waste not night, and then the crew fail according to the words of the Lord, and which he spake by the prophet Elijah. And you know that he was the prophet of faith. Amen. He was the prophet of faith. Can you have the faith, amen, that the prophet Elijah had? Amen. He believed what God said he did, what he said do. Amen. And you know God just spoke and said, I'm going to have the raven to Eli. I'm going to have the raven to feed the bread in the morning and drink in the morning, bread and drink, flesh and bread in the evening. And you could drink from the brook. And then he told him, I'm going to have a widow woman to sustain thee. Amen. Amen. So as he went. And not only that, amen, in verse 19, in chapter 19, amen, he would have the angel of the Lord, amen, to sustain him. Amen. Can we say amen? Yes, we have God and angels. Amen. We have we may not be able to see them, but we, every last one of us, have a guardian angel. Amen. Can we say amen? Shall we say amen again? And then we look at verse 17, and I'm moving along, I'm going to do briefly. And it came to pass that these things that the Son of Man in the midst of the house fell sick. Amen. And his sickness was sore, and amen, that there was no left in his body, the woman's son. And then he said unto Elijah, What have I done? What have I to do with thee? O thou man of God, art thou come unto me to call my sins to remembrance and to slay me? See, this woman, she was not saved. She was a sinner. Amen. And her lifestyle wasn't good. Amen. Can we say amen? But she believed God. The Bible says, and he said unto her, give me thy son. And he took him out of her bosom. And the Bible said, and carried him up into the loft, amen, abroad, and then laid him on the bed. And he began to cry out unto God. This is what the prophet did. Begin to cry out before the Lord. And this is the time that we're in now. The time that we ought to be crying out. Amen. Before the Lord. It's time to cry out. We're living in a pandemic. Amen. We're living in a time, amen, may not be as worse as it was then. Amen. But we are living in a time that we've never seen before. People that we know next door just dying. They're dropping dead. Amen. People that we know. Amen. They're leaving here. Amen. And they're leaving here at an alarming rate. Amen. And people are to begin now to cry out to the Lord. And that's what time it is. It's time to cry out to God. Amen. And this is what Elijah did. He began to cry out unto the Lord and began to talk to God. He said, he cried out to the Lord, oh Lord my God. Amen. Hath thou brought evil upon this widow, amen, with whom I sojourn, amen, by slaying her son. Amen. He stretched himself, the Bible say, out upon the child three times and cried unto the Lord again. And the Bible said that the Lord heard him. Amen. Don't you know that when you cry out, amen, to the Lord, he knows a sincere cry when you cry out unto him. Amen. He cried unto God, and the Bible says in verse 21 that God heard Elijah. And the Bible said the soul of the child came again into the body of the child and revived him. And he came back to life. Amen. Can we say amen? He came back to life, and the Bible said he took the child and took him back to his mother, and the woman acknowledged that he was a man of God. Amen. Can we say amen? Nobody can do those kind of miracles except they be of God. Amen. Can we say amen? And shall we say amen again? Yes, these are the times. These are hard, difficult times. These are the times that the devil comes to try the souls of men, women, girls, and boys. These are times, amen, that we're going to have to rise up from where we are. Let go and let God have his way in our life. When nothing else seems to be working, we need to turn to Jesus, because we know that he has worked miracles in your life before. And then we lack what he did, and somehow or another we turn our deaf ear to what he was doing. We turn our back on him. And the same thing happening to us now again, but only it's in a person, only it's at a different rate. And it's worse than what it was before. And it said, and here we say, like Elijah said, and he took the child and brought the child, amen, down out of the chamber and gave him back to his mother. And the Bible says here, and the son, the woman said unto Elijah, now I know, yeah, amen, I know that thou art a man of God, amen, and that the word of God is in thy mouth, amen. Can we say amen? Oh, I want you to know that the time is now. It's time to rise up from where you are. Let go and let God have his way in your life. Amen. This is the same thing that Daniel did. Amen. Daniel cried out to the Lord 3 times a day. Amen. The Bible says in Daniel 6:10, it said, now when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, amen, he went into his house, and his window being opened and the chamber toward Jerusalem. The Bible said he kneeled 3 times before God and prayed. Amen. And gave thanks to God, as he did many of times. Amen. It's time to kneel and talk to the Lord. It's time to do like Hezekiah did. Hezekiah, the Bible said, he turned to the east and he looked and he prayed to God. And the Bible said that God added 15 years unto his life. I don't know how many years God gonna add to your life, but I tell you, when you look to him, God's gonna add something. He's gonna do something special. It's time to rise up, let go, and let God have his way. Amen. It's time to, amen. Just cause the times are bad does not mean there's no good news. Amen. Happens on the way. Happens on the way. It makes no difference how bad it look or how grim it look. We still have a God that sits high and look low, who sees everything. His eyes scan the whole horizon, and nothing goes unseen behind the all-seeing eyes of God. It's time to get up from where you are. Let go and let God have his way in your life. The Bible says in Matthew 11:28, come unto me all ye that labor are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest for you to your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. It's time to rise up. If you want relief, amen, from fatigue, amen, look to Jesus. Amen. If you want relief from heavy burdens, amen, look to Jesus. If you want wisdom, if you want truth, if you want knowledge, look to Jesus. It's time to look to Jesus and cry out unto him. Amen. If you're looking for, if you want salvation, look to Jesus. Amen. Because he's not willing that any should perish, but that all men come unto repentance. Amen. Can we say amen? Yes, God wants to save you. He wants to deliver you. He wants to set you free. He wants to change conditions in your mind, soul, and body. Amen. Can we say amen? Shall we say amen again? Why don't you just lift your hands and tell the Lord thank you?
Thank you, Lord.
Can you just lift your hands and tell him thank you?
Thank you, Lord.
He's the wonder all by himself. Amen. And we can lift our hands to a wonder. And God can make you a wonder in the land. He can make you a terror in the land that we live in. Won't y'all just tell the Lord thank you?
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, tell him thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. When we pray, we expect God to move. Amen. We expect touch somebody and deliver somebody. And I just believe that though that many of these, amen, that are sick and look like they weren't gonna make it, I just believe that the prayers of the righteous has availed. They have raised them up, amen. And now they have hope. And now they have life. They can rise up because now they have hope. Amen. And they can do the things that they used to do and begin to cry out more unto the Lord. Amen. Can we say amen? They are vessels unto the Lord. Amen. They are vessels. Amen. And what God needs is more vessels. I just don't believe that God can get enough of vessels. Amen. And so our job is to continue to pray for those. Amen. That are down. Those that are helpless. Amen. Those that need help. amen, in every area of life, amen. We look around and we see it. We look around and we see bad news. We cut the television off, bad news. And we walk outside on the street, bad news. Even sometime in our household, bad news. And it seems like, wherever, no matter where we look and how often we look, we don't see good news nowhere. But you can pick your Bible up. You can go in your room and shut your door. Get on your knees. Begin to cry to the Lord. And then your heart, open your heart up to the Lord. And then good news appear. There's good news in His Word. Amen. Good news in what He says. And good news in what He does. And when you pray out to the Lord, amen, God begins to move in your heart. And it don't take Him long to move. Amen. Don't take God long to move. Amen. And when He moves, something happens. Amen. Your faith rises up in you. And you begin to do things that you didn't think that you could do. Yes, but it's because faith moves God. Faith plows through. Faith does not have a reverse gear, but faith plows through mountains. Amen. And heavy, high terrain. Faith does not have a reverse gear. And that's the kind of person that God's looking for. That's who he wants. Amen. To be called the harvest is plenished and the labels are few. Amen. But we are right now in the vineyard, amen, there's a shortage of labels, amen. So we're crying out to God that He may send forth labels into the vineyard, amen, that people are saved, amen, that they may be escaped, that may escape the wrath to come. And that's what it said that He was going to do to the church. He said He was going to protect the church and keep it from the wrath to come. And I want to be in that number. Amen. Amen. When the man of sin, amen, comes on the scene, amen, I want to get up in the first resurrection if I'm alive. Amen. I want to be caught up to go back and be with the Lord and be with Him, amen, at the supper there in the heavens. Amen. Can we say amen? Amen. Shall we say amen again? Amen. Shall we say amen again? Amen. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we thank You, O God, for all things. We thank You, Lord, for Your outstretched hand. We thank You for Your touch. We thank You for all that we've done, that You've done and that You're going to do. We ask You to stretch forth Your hands of deliverance, Lord, and bind the enemy of the devil. Bind the enemy of the sea. Cast them out of the man in the will of all. Stretch out Your hands, Lord, and shake by Your power. Cover Your people, Lord, with Your blood. In the name of Jesus, stretch out Your hand and look on those families, Lord, that's affected by the coronavirus. Those, Lord, that have lost loved ones, cover them with Your blood, Lord. Keep them in Your will today, Lord. Let them know that You're in control and on top of everything. Oh, God, we believe You today. We believe Your word because Your word is life and Your word gives life. In the name of Jesus, Satan, the Lord rebuke you. The word of God is against you. I charge you by the authority of Jesus to loose your hold here. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Look on those that are sick, those that are bound, those that are going through. Look on in the name of Jesus. Look on the family of our bishop, our pastor of the Roger, the Taylor family, the Walker family, and keep them in Your will, O God. In the name of Jesus. Lord, have Your way. Have Your way in these end times, in these hard, difficult, dangerous times. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Speak to the hearts of Your people. Words of wisdom and words of understanding. Give them the know that You're God and on top of everything. In the name of Jesus. Lord, bless in a mighty way. Bless both natural and spiritual. Rebuke death here, there, and everywhere. Give us to say yes, Lord, to Your word and to Your will. In the name of Jesus. We seek You for all things. We seek You for deliverance. We claim deliverance. And we claim the victory. In the name of Jesus. Those that are bound, Lord. Those that are bed confined. Raise them up, O God. In the name of Jesus. Raise them up. Let them come out in victory with their hands up, O God. In the name of Jesus. Bless in a mighty way. Bless both natural and spiritual, Lord. These that are gathered here. Dear Lord, look on God as the rulers everywhere. Give them to make righteous decision for Your people, O God. Lord, these blessings and others we ask in Jesus' name. Thank God. Thank God.
The same is blessed.